Today's gospel passage is chock full of varied emotions, depending on who exactly you would want to focus on. Jairus, whose daughter lay dying, must have felt distraught. The woman with bleeding problems for all of 12 years must have felt hopeful and determined to touch, at the very least, the hem of the Lord's garments. There was wailing and intense sorrowing when Jairus's daughter was believed to have succumbed and died. Never mind if those who wailed were only doing the wailing for ritualistic and cultural motives. But there was one emotion that is most surprising, for it came from the same ones who did the wailing, and that was short of nothing but contempt for the Lord. They ridiculed the Lord for telling everyone that the girl was not dead, but was merely sleeping. We all could very well fit in today's gospel scenario. Who has not experienced the pain of losing someone dear? Who among us did not feel contemptuous of other people we do not particularly like or believe in? Who among us does not understand what it means to be on the verge of losing someone so close to us? Having those feelings and more is not a tragedy at all. Feelings, after all, are neither good nor bad. They are just simply that, feelings that come and go. But we are also familiar with what counselors call mixed feelings. We could at any given time feel like wailing, but in the same breath we could also be contemptuous and in the mood to ridicule other people. But today's gospel, among so many others, is a lesson for those who wail and those who ridicule, those who feel intense sorrow and those who feel equally intense anger. The Lord today shows himself beyond feeling, beyond contempt, beyond anger, and beyond sorrow. Whilst he obviously felt compassion for Jairus, he was not bothered in the least by the contemptuous remarks and behavior of those who ridiculed him for saying what he said and doing what he eventually did. Trabaho lang, ika nga, walang personalan. It was just a simple matter of doing what was right. It was simply a matter of fulfilling the Father's will and doing wonders in spite of the fact that people around him were in no mood to appreciate those same wonders. There was only one thing that mattered in the end, and that was doing what was right. That is, doing the Father's will, never mind the wailing and the ridiculing. And this, my dear friends, is your Kalakbay at Katotoy in today's episode, 13th Sunday, of Puso sa Puso, saying thank you and God bless you.